Hi, this is Vinnie Vincent. You've just heard me play some of the solos from All Systems Go, my new album out on Chrysalis Records. Today we're going to try to cover as much of the style that I do and what makes up the patterns I use, such as arpeggios, sweeps, alternate picking, rhythmic right-hand picking, pull-offs, hammer-ons. We're going to try to cover everything. And before we do, let's try to get in tune for ourselves so we can play together. And here's my E. B. G. D. A. And E. In this section, I'd like to show you some of the scale patterns that I use and how I break the licks down. Basically, in the key of E, we go to the 12th fret, and it's based on a minor pentatonic scale, and I throw a few notes in, and chromatically, you can hear how it starts to develop. Let me show you the notes in the scale so you can begin to see what notes are available to you. Extra notes that you can play without being caught up in the same old thing. We'll start with the major third. We'll also add the major seventh note, which usually people don't use on a blues pentatonic scale. Dominant seventh, sixth, five, and the flatted five, which is your pentatonic. Major third again. And if you were really to run them together and get the right rhythmic pattern in your own style, if you would, or try to learn what I'm doing, in the right hand pulse you would pick up. Let's take another shape, also in the key of E. And it's a pretty easy one if you really just check it out. And put together, you can get this. Let me show you a bit of the neck patterns that I use and how I view the guitar. And I usually take a span of 4 to 5 to 6 frets. Let's start up here at the 12th fret. We're going to go 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. From these 5 frets here, when I look at that, I pretty much see every note in there I can play, just about every note. Chromatically, it all works. You know, when you hear it in the context of a pulsating pattern, you can really hear how that works. Believe it or not, all the notes actually do work. And also, I'm looking at this section from these 4 frets right here, which is 7, 8, 9 to the 12th. There's four frets here that have a full range of almost every note, again, you can play in this pattern. Then I'll take that and I'll see these 4 frets, number 6 through 9, and I see another E pattern in there. Also, chromatically, flat 5s and all that stuff can really be used in there also. Then again, I will see another pattern right in here. And when I play on a E pattern in this section here, I basically am playing over a B natural chord. Okay, and that's how I see my E pattern here. Let me show you some phrases in each section of what I just pointed out to you. This will be random. I'll just pull it out of my hat and see what we got. Okay, that was in this 5-note pattern here, the spread right here. I'm getting basically almost every note. I'm getting on your first string, on your second string, on your third string, almost chromatically, right down the E scale, but it's the way you place it and how you can put it together that makes it work. Let's go down to this 4-fret span right here. Now, we can do a similar lick, the same, using the same notes and picking, and you'll see how that works. Okay, now when I see E and this pattern right here, I'm going to add this dominant 7th note right here on the 10th fret, and I'll get this one. And that brings me right down to my 3rd right here. Also, when I get down to this pattern here, I see basically a B chord. And realizing when I see a B chord, I can play it here, and I can play B here. Let me clarify when I say I think in the terms of playing in the key of B. It's not really a B chord I see, but it's actually an E major 9 chord, which is this. But I see the pattern and the block of scales and pattern as far as the position on the neck, I see it as this. And I'm also seeing a B7 note in there, okay? And if I play these notes in this scale, I in my rhythmic pattern would hear. And there you have notes that are generally not in the scale, but also there this time to give it just a little bit different tonality that your ear sometimes, it perks up when you hear something a little different. I know mine does when I hear someone play something that, wow, I never thought of using that. Again, in the key of E, you also have another section of notes that are completely open and free to use. And you could be playing in the key of D and open up again another world of melodic intervals. Again, that would catch your ear in something that was slightly a little bit more interesting than playing just in the key of E. And in the key of D, you have major 7th, major 6th, 9s, and basically what you have is here. Okay, and you also have it here. All right, picture this D here, and you're gonna, actually, let's do this. Picture this D. Okay, and let's think of this triad here. Let's think of this triad. Let's think of this one. And let's think of this. Okay, now if you wanna use some of those, you have. And you also have it here. Now again, think of this right here. That's basically a D major 7th with a B minor 7th. Now, you know an octave of this is here. Okay? Take that same shape and come up here, and you have. You have. Okay, that starts to connect your E notes to your D notes. Okay. And you have. Okay. Now those are all melodic ideas that open up another door. We have one other interesting place we can go that we haven't touched on yet. But if you can envision this chord, and I'll turn down the volume so you can hear. It's like an E major 6th, 9, and it sounds like this. Okay, when I see that, I see this scale. It's really your E note flatted, one down. And you can see that this chord here. And you can also envision an F sharp chord over an E bass. which gives you... And again, let me give you just another scale pattern and another position that you can also use in the key of E, which again has another interesting tonality all its own. It's an E minor scale with the major seventh note. I'd like to talk to you a bit about my picking technique. It started out when I was quite young, and I used to use all my fingers to pluck the notes on the guitar. And my parents always listened to country and western music, and my father played steel guitar, and my mother sang at times, and they always had musicians over the house most of the time. So I'd hear country and western players most often, you know, in my early youth. And I was fascinated by chicken picking, you know, and sometimes to do that, you know, you use your other fingers. But it worked itself into my style over the years, and so I can use alternate picking and switch to my fingers at the same time. Here's an example of how it works with my middle fingers picking the strings with the alternate picking. Let me show you the arpeggio with the added third finger in there for picking. Let me demonstrate that playing a D chord pattern in triads over an E bass. So you still have, okay, it's still your root. This is what we're discussing of all these licks. E is still your root. Okay, picture this chord. Then. Okay, and you're going to get... I'll do that again. Still over this. Okay, and you're getting... And you can bring that up, again, into the E chord. Same chord, same moves, only in the E. And that is still happening over your E bass. So you have another interesting rhythmic concept. Also, tonality-wise and harmonically, it opens up another world. Many times people approach me, you know, young guitarists wanting to, you know, learn what I do. And a lot of the questions is, how do you develop the speed in your playing and that pulse that goes along with it? And my recommendation is something that, you know, I learned on, which is very simple. It's just a chromatic 4-fret movement on each string with alternate picking on this hand, and you start to develop it. You can pretty much stay in one position, but it helps as you, you know, move up the fret. You know, you're getting a bit more speed in your right hand. But that would help you to start increasing your picking style. Now, all I did there was to just move the pattern down a few strings. And if you do that a number of times a day, you'll start to feel the movement, you know, starting to become easier and easier. Things like that. This exercise of that 4-note span really starts to put you into your own rhythm anyway. And then as you're feeling that, it becomes easier and easier. When I'm looking for speed picking, I use an alternate picking style, which we all know is... And, you know, you have your alternating lines that you can... When I want the accent, though, in the alternate picking, I add the second finger, which gives me an added accent in the rhythm of the phrase. So I'll start with alternate picking, and then you'll hear... And when I added that, you heard an added extra pull on the rhythm. That rhythm of that pulse moving is gotten by using the second finger and sometimes the third finger as pulls on the rhythm on certain strings. So you get that, you just have that in-between rhythm that you can't get when you do alternate picking. So that helps me achieve a little bit something that's different when people listen to it. They hear, hey, that's, how'd you do that, you know? And it's really basically from... you know, chicken picking stuff, which is done, which was really done by most country players. And, you know, like, I, for myself, I used it incorporated into my style, and now it's become, you know, a major part of it. So we have the alternate picking again. And here's what it would sound like with the picking in it. And if you want to try to incorporate the extra pull in the picking fingers here, a good exercise would be... And the faster you do it... And again, you can... That whole movement combined with the alternate picking and all the open areas you have to really fish out what it is you're looking for do open more worlds to you. I'd like to introduce to you at this time a little classical run that involves string skipping and an E major triad and an E flat diminished run, and it sounds like this. And sometimes you'll hear violin players play that and slowly demonstrate it. That would sound like this. Let me show you one more riff here that uses the same string skipping and the rhythmic pull. And fast it will be. What I'm doing really is I'm getting your E major scale going backwards. Thank you. I'm skipping from the E string to the G string, then the B string to the D string, then to G string to the A string. And really, all you're using are the notes in the E scale, just a basic E major scale. I'd like to show you an example of sweep picking, and it's part of an arpeggio that as you build up speed, you can sweep it down and back up. But what you should start with now, we're going to have an E7 flat 5 chord that's also very playable in the key of E. And it would be... Alright, as you're sweeping that, here's the sweep motion. Now faster it would be. Those are all examples of sweeping. I'd like to show you now some open string scales involving the A harmonic minor. Also, again, over your E bass. And it'll give you this kind of attention. And that would be something like this. Okay, now faster it would be. And it'll create an interesting feel against, you know, a track where you're blowing, you're doing scales, and all of a sudden you break into an open string, kind of a country lick, really, because most country players use that. Let's go with that slow again. Open. Use that picking finger again. Again, that same second finger. Again, open on the D. Again, open on the A. And it would be like this. We'll be right back. In this section, I'm going to show you some of the licks and show you how to do some of the things you've just heard. And we should have fun with this because it's going to open up a new tonality for you and try to train your ear to hear different things that are not so obvious. And try to have fun with it all, because in the end result, the more you explore the guitar, the more you're going to get out of it. And I'm going to show you how I basically lay out the neck in the key of E in this section, and show you positions and a number of licks that if you string them all together, you can start putting the passages together and see where it takes you. So let's begin. We're in E, and here we go. Okay, now I'm going to slow that down for you, and note the pulling of your second finger, and that'll give you partial rhythm of that part itself, and this is what you get slowing it down. Done again slow. Then downward on the picking. One more time. This is a Spanish bolero lick in the key of E. Slowing it down, we'll get this, and what you should be noticing is the roll of the pick and the two fingers behind it, and you'll get this. Here it is again fast. Okay, here's another one in the key of E over the ninth position, which is these four frets here. Now, slowing that down, we will get this. Fast again. Okay, here we are again in the key of E, and I usually play this over power chords. E power chord again. And it's kind of a jazzy lick, but it's over the seventh position, and it's over an E9 flat 5 chord, which is this. Now the lick itself is... Okay, that involves a sweeping on your first arpeggio, and slow, we would have this. Okay, the sweeping technique is done by just brushing your pick over the strings consecutively, and this lick is made up primarily of a B minor chord, and slowing it down, you'll get... And it's also alternate picking with that. So you have... Slowing it down again. Okay, here's another one in the key of E, starting at the 7th fret and ending at the 12th. Okay, slowing that down. We'll get the same pattern run consecutively from your first string all the way down to your fifth. And it's the same pattern on each string, beginning here. Fast, we have it again. Okay, here's another set of arpeggiated licks in the key of E, coupled with a lick we have already learned. I will give you the new lick first. And it's a sweep down from your ninth position to your seventh position. Okay, here's that lick coupled with the previous lick we already learned. Now, slowing that whole lick down, we'll get... Okay, here's another one in the key of E. This is a chromatic pedal tone in the ninth position, starting from your third of your E. Okay, slowing that down, we have this. Okay, notice my right hand picking technique on this particular lick, and it begins with the second finger pulling on your third of your E, and it's alternating between a down picking, alternate picking, and the finger picking. So you're going to have... Okay, also in the key of E, here's two licks played together, and I'll play them fast and then break it down for you. Okay, let's slow that down. Again, the lick being in the key of E, we're starting with a D chord, and it's a sweep, and we covered that before. The sweep was just a pick gracefully sliding over the strings, and slowing that down, we have... Here's that lick again, played fast. And now I'm going to show you the pedal tone part to connect with this particular lick that I just showed you. Now, slowing that down, I want you to get a position, a look at the position of my fingers when I'm picking this. Again, I'm starting with the second finger, your index finger, and alternating with your pick finger, your first, and it's going like this. Now, the whole lick put together will sound... Okay, this is one of my favorites, also in the key of E. It's an E7 flat 9 flat 5, played over your E power chord. So you're getting that scale based out of that chord. It's on your sixth position, and it's going to involve skipping strings. Your sixth to your fourth, your fifth to your third, your fourth to your second, and your third to your first. And I'll slow it down, and this is what you get. Okay, here's a variation on that last pattern starting on E. I'll slow down and increase the speed as we go on. Thank you. Here's a descending lick, based from the same scale, and I'll start it fast and then slow it down for you. Okay, now slow. I'm using the same picking technique, and I'll angle the guitar so you can get a good view of it. I'm starting with this second finger, your index finger, and I'm pulling. Okay, it's your same 4-2-1 jumping strings, okay? So we're going from first string to third string. 4-2-1. Now we're skipping, we're going straight to the second string, and we're using 4-3-1, and we're going to do the same 4-3-1 on the fourth string. Okay, so we got. Now we're going to move down here, and we're going to use the same picking. Okay, now we're going to stop here and continue to move back on upward again, involving E7 sweeps, arpeggios, okay? So we're coming back from. Let me slow that down for you. Show you another set of series of licks involving the same whole tone scale and pattern, which will take your tonality out a bit, still in the key of E, but give you something that your ear seems to pick up. I like hearing things like that every now and then, out of a blur of, you know, things that are really in the pocket. Then you hear a whole tone scale. It's an interesting scale to me. I'll try to play it fast and slow it down for you. Okay, now that's still all in the key of E. Now let me show you that slow. Now the thing I love about it is it's still in the key of E. Okay, on the D arpeggios that we were just doing, this here. Are really forms of the B minor chord. You'll hear that. It's very minor sounding, but over an E bass. You hear that tonality? It's still pleasing to the ear. Still, E. Okay, here's a descending lick involving our D major triads. and our F diminished arpeggio. Okay, now we're going to turn that back into coming up right down on your... Okay, I'm going to play it fast and then slow it down for you. Okay, here's that lick slowed down quite a bit. Okay, here's a series of flat fives. Okay, I'm going to slow that down. And again, I want you to take a look at the picking angle and the alternate between the pick and my index finger. Okay, one more time, fast. Okay, here's a hammer-on technique, a chromatic one at that, in the fifth position that I used on Boys Are Gonna Rock, and a lot of guitar players had asked me how I did that, and it's involving pull-offs on the left hand and hammering with the right. Here we are. This is a double-handed hammer technique slowed down. Well, that brings us to the end of our tape, and I know I had a great time, and I hope you all did too. I'd like to thank Roger Hutchinson, Martine Mayo, Steve Trovato, and Keith Wyatt. Thanks, guys, for doing a great job and getting me through this video. It was great fun, and I hope to see you all in your town, and keep playing that rock and roll.